So on the 3rd of April, Balfour Beatty were called out to Nuneham Viaduct following an emergency call out by Network Rail. Network Rail had made the decision to close the railway as the structure behind me could no longer safely support trains. It was a big decision by Network Rail to close it, causing massive disruption to their network. The DCL line is one of the main arterial routes for Network Rail carrying freight from Southampton to the rest of the country. And over the last 66 days, Balfour Beatty have worked tirelessly to rebuild this embankment and bridge abutment, re-land the structure and reopen to traffic.
Responding so quickly to a really important need was phenomenal. Why has that been successful? Well, I think the relationship we've got over working together for a long time, the teamwork, the collaboration, the ability to bring in specialist subcontractors to work with design, it's just been a phenomenal effort by everyone and we're truly grateful.
The first thing that we needed to do was try and stabilise the existing bridge. So that involved mobilising barges on the Thames, which we then installed THS piles into the river. Those THS piles formed the foundation for a propping system that we installed, and off that propping system we then jacked the bridge. So with the bridge then in the air, we were able to demolish the existing abutment and then start excavating the embankment behind. We installed THS piles, which formed the basis of the new abutment foundation. Sill beams on top of that to hold the bridge, and then we installed a box pile wall behind the CHS piles to retain the earth. Backfilled, and then it was time to put the track back on again.
The project faced several challenges. Chief amongst these was the timescales with which we had to deliver it. What would traditionally be an 18-month to 2-year job, we managed to do in 66 days. So the job itself has been quite intrusive on the local community, but the silver linings from this include some of our spend with the local community.
Whilst we've been here, we have been working with the local school, the local community and the landowners here to make sure we're at least disruptive as possible and engage with them and show them what we're doing as we work through the programme.
So the only way that we could achieve this project successfully was collaborating with both the client and all of our supply chain to make one team from the start, pulling in the client and our key suppliers into our decision-making process from planning, tail design, into construction and out the other end into handback.